Hi everyone, it's Leslie coming to you live from, sorry, I wanted to make sure it was live. I wasn't seeing anything. Hi, this is Leslie coming to you live with another episode of Love Where You Live, Give Where You Love. As always, would love for you to share questions, comments. I always love the hearts and the likes. Hi Phil, thanks for joining. And while we wait for everyone to hop on to this episode, just want to let you know that in the description, hi Colleen, thanks for joining. In the description, there is a download of a calendar of events here in Orange County. This is my print off of it. Unfortunately, my printer is on the fritz, or my magenta ink is out, so I only have a black and white version. But as you'll see, again, in the description section, there is a download your calendar here, so you can go ahead and download this calendar and find out all the cool events in that are going on right now in Orange County. Hi Mike, thanks for joining. So definitely download this, check it out. Look and see what are you possibly adding to your calendar. Hi Kim, thanks for joining. And look at it, did we forget anything? And of course, keep thinking of the questions that you might want to ask. And what are you looking forward to in April? I know that Kim, you might be looking forward to today, because today is your daughter's 13th birthday. So happy birthday to Cameron. And of course, Phil, I'm sure you're thrilled because today is Harper's birthday as well. So happy birthday to my niece and goddaughter Harper. I know that I have a lot of birthdays and lots of birthday shout outs for the month of April, because today is, like I said, my niece's birthday, and then tomorrow is my father-in-law's birthday, and then it's their anniversary, and then it's my son's 13th birthday, and my brother-in-law's birthday. So lots of birthdays for our family in the month of April. Hi, Mike. Thanks for joining. Hi, Jen and Alexis. Thank you guys for joining as well. So comments, tell me, what are you guys looking forward to in April? And I apologize, apparently a helicopter likes to go over right now. So if you hear that helicopter, I apologize. But again, super excited. Today is a nice, it started off as a foggy day, but is a great sunny day now here in South Orange County. And, you know, just looking forward to all the fun and exciting events that are coming up this spring and taking us right into the summer. So as far as on this calendar, one of the things that I'm most excited about is actually coming up this weekend, which is the Aquatic Center, the Marguerite Aquatic Center reopening. I have watched them build or tear it down and then build it the past couple of years. Our kids have had swim meets there, and so it now, as from what I can see from the outside, looks like a beautiful facility and very state-of-the-art. I am very excited to see what it looks like actually from the inside, and hopefully that will bring a lot more swimming talent to the area. There are people actually that come from all over the world to train with some of the coaches that work with the Nattadores swim team, which practice at the Marguerite Aquatic Center. So super excited to see now that we have a state-of-the-art facility, what that will do for the Mission Viejo swimming programs and reputation. So again, any questions, comments, loves, likes, feel free to share them with me. Mike, I'm seeing that you are looking forward to taking your mobile headquarters on a trip to Zion and Bryce National Parks. Very exciting. Those are two places that I've never been, but I have always wanted to go because I've heard so many people say wonderful things. Are you going soon in the spring or this month, Mike? Let's see, Colleen, you're looking forward to seeing the Marguerite Aquatic Center as well. That's fantastic. Jenny, thanks for joining. So again, April, oh, there is one thing that I did leave off that my son, when he saw this, thought, Mom, I can't believe you didn't include it. On April 14th, There is actually a Comic-Con event at the Mission Viejo Library. So they're going to have different authors and just a fun Comic-Con event at the Mission Viejo Library, which obviously it's probably not going to be to the caliber of what they have in downtown San Diego every year, but still a neat event nonetheless, especially for kids these days who don't necessarily read comic books maybe as much as our generation or our parents' generation. So I just think it's super cool that kids of young and old actually get to experience the fun of reading comics and comic book characters and all that stuff right here in Mission Viejo. So that is something that like I said, I left off the calendar, but if you want to add it to your calendar, definitely do. It's April 14th at the Mission Viejo Library. And you're going to, and Mike, I see that you're going in the end of April to Zion and Bryce National Parks. That's awesome. So definitely something to look forward to. Fantastic. So again, if there's anything that you have any questions about with this calendar, I'll continue to hold it and show it to you, because this is something that when you go to the website or the blog, you will actually see a link that says click here to download this calendar. So you can simply print it off. I always prefer to save paper and print two-sided. So that's why you will see mine on both sides. But this is something that you too can print and put up on your bulletin board or whatever as or whatever, wherever you store important dates, as something to just be a nice reminder so that you know the important events that are going on in the month of April. So again, that is something that if you simply go to www.theswanteamoc.com and click on the tab blog, you will see it's the most recent post about the April upcoming events. So definitely check that out. And like I said, please share with me any events that you want, that you think maybe were either left out or some of those fun events that you'd like to check out, because we'd love to know. Now, of course, one thing that I want to share with you, or that I like to always kind of touch upon in all of our episodes of Love Where You Live, Give Where You Love, is the story behind where that motto came from. As I have mentioned to many people, but I can never say it enough, I have helped at my children's school for several years now, and I have enjoyed doing that very much. But my idea of loving where you live and giving where you love, and donation from what I do as a realtor came almost out of necessity when I was sitting at a PTA meeting one day and was listening to the line items of what the PTA paid for. And the one that struck a chord with me the most, which it wasn't that it was a significant cost, it's just the fact that it wasn't covered by the district, which was the call-in sick phone line. It seems like a no-brainer, but it was something that the Parent Teacher Association has to pay for on a monthly basis that the district does not cover. And of course, then you have your art, your music, your STEAM programs, all those things that, you know, unfortunately, the district just doesn't have the funds for, or doesn't fund the schools enough to get students where teachers would like to see them go. So again, that's the genesis of the Love Where You Live, Give Where You Love donation program, in which I donate $500 to any school of your choice, school PTA or program of your choice, for every house that I help you buy or sell. It's that simple. You know, it's not rocket science or brain surgery. I just want to give back and make sure that you love where you live. And of course, I will take care of the give where you love part. And this is just one way that we like to give back to the community. Obviously, I like to volunteer my time at the schools as well. Clearly, because I am a parent of a 10-year-old and an almost 13-year-old, that is where my heart is many hours of the day. But there are a lot of other causes that I certainly believe in, and certainly would be more than happy, you know, to continue helping you love where you live and give where you love. So always want to make sure that everyone is aware of that. So another, this is kind of an more informal episode of Love Where You Live, Give Where You Love. Questions. Do you want to see something new or different from us, the SWAN team, as far as any of our posts, as far as any of our Facebook Live videos? Is there something that you'd like to see that's new and different? Obviously, we're trying to share with you what we think is the most important information that we could provide for you. But of course, we don't want to live in a bubble, and we want to make sure that we get your input and feedback as well. So again, please feel free to comment and let us know if there are any particular things that you'd like to see us talk about or share or provide resources for. We'd love to help. Again, whether it's real estate or neighborhood related, we want to be your go-to resource for everything Orange County. And in order to do that, we definitely need your feedback and your questions. So feel free to post below or message us or call us to let us know exactly what information you're looking for and that, you know, can better serve you, because ideally we are in the service business and we are here to serve you and to make sure that you are loving where you live every day and every step of the way. So of course, again, remember in the comments or in the description of this post, there is a downloadable Orange County event calendar for the month of April. So definitely check that out. Have your own printout. And of course, I mean, why wouldn't you want to carry around a lovely picture with me on it anyway? So definitely. Hi, Sylvia. Thanks for joining. So of course, always remember that this is downloadable. Like I said, in the description, you can always go to the website and the blog and find this information as well as information about us. So always keep that in mind. Jenny, I see that you always love our home tours. Oh, so you'd like to find some places that people can volunteer at or in the community. We definitely love to pull that together. I know there are a lot of places, as I had mentioned before too, with, as I feel like it's kind of silly, but it's kind of fun. You know, the grocery stores right now are having that Monopoly game, Albertsons, Vons, Pavilions. They're all having that fun game right now. And if you take those little pieces, some of the pieces are actually free items that you can get, like cans of soup or aspirin, or those are just some, and gravy mix, random things. But needless to say, things that, you know, maybe you don't personally need, and instead of throwing them away, you can actually go pick up those items from the grocery store and you can donate that to your local food pantry. Obviously, one of the local food pantries here is the St. Killian Food Bank. But Jenny, thank you so much for the suggestion. We can definitely pull together some different options of volunteering opportunities, whether, you know, for people of all ages. I know some kids are even looking for volunteer hours for school programs or organizations they're part of. So we can definitely look for those. So thank you so much for asking about that, Jenny. We appreciate it. So again, we have the downloadable calendar, as always, too. We always greatly appreciate all of the clients that get referred to us. So any family, friends that you refer to us always mean the world to us, and always know that we will treat them like they are our family, because that's how we want to be treated. So again, thank you so much for all of your referrals, and please continue sending them our way. We'd love to take great care of them and find them the right home for them, and what best suits their needs. So if there aren't any other comments or questions, would love to hear more of you. Thank you. I'm seeing all these really fun thumbs up, and of course, oh, I forgot. Wows are always fun too, and loves. and I've seen some of those. So thank you so much. Those always make my day. The one question I did also forget to ask is if anyone wants to share, it's kind of late now, but if anyone wants to share where they're joining from, I'm always curious where you are coming from. It can be as specific as your dining room, but ideally the city location would be great too. Hi, Stephanie. Thanks for joining. Hi, Craig. Thanks for joining. So again, look in the description for the downloadable Orange County event calendar for the month of April. We will continue providing those for you because we do want to be your go-to resource for everything Orange County, whether it's real estate related or neighborhood related. And of course, if you ever want to know how much your home is worth or are thinking of potentially purchasing a property, a second property, or a new property, always give us a call because we'd love to help walk you through the step-by-step process and finding out what is feasible for you. If you have a dream out there and you want to achieve it, we'd love to help. So that is all that I have. Thank you so much for joining, everyone. I hope everyone has a great Wednesday. And as always, remember to love where you live and give where you love. Take care.